going forward in for all of the major jobs that will pay a great salary, six figures or more. It's going to have a STEM base, either science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. In the early 60s and the 50s, a lot of focus was on agriculture and manufacturing. But it's been a huge change and shift. Now it's STEM, science, technology, and engineering, and mathematics. So in order to be internationally competitive, we're going to have to be able to afford our children the facilities in order to be able to be competitive on the international level. Whitehaven is a very traditional school. We hadn't had any major infrastructure changes since the beginning in the early 1900s. We had an addition added in 1998. We had an addition of the auditorium. But since then, we haven't had many changes. These labs and these workstations have been here since the 40s. No change in over 60 years. These workstations haven't changed. Many of the things here don't work. You don't have operating water nor operating gas. But yet and still, these children are going to have to try to compete with children who've had exposure to labs that work, that are with the coordinates of the 21st century. But our children still are doing very, very well, but they don't have the access or the opportunities to work with working equipment.
You'd be surprised at what we make happen in order to best educate the students that we have with very little. And having that STEM facility would give us more, not just for Whitehaven, not for just the Empowerment Zone, but for those individuals in the 38109 and 38116 in the Whitehaven community. They deserve to have those experiences, and that will also help the teacher.
This new STEM facility is going to be a huge undertaking for our entire community. We really appreciate Mr. Richard Myers and the major donor, which is a former Whitehaven graduate, Jim Herbert, who graduated from Whitehaven in 1958. Jim Herbert donated $2 million to our overall project cost of $6.25 million. So this entire project of this new STEM building for the Whitehaven community and the Whitehaven Empowerment Zone is going to cost approximately $6.25 million. This is where it's going to be right here. It's where it's going to face Whitehaven Lane. It's going to be a $6.25 million building that's going to change the lives of our entire community. Can you believe this? You're going to have elementary children who are going to work in the state-of-the-art labs that can work with hands-on activities with robotics. They're going to work in labs that look just like, if not better, than the University of Memphis, UT Knox, built right here, state-of-the-art. They're going to have a STEMnasium. Instead of a gymnasium, a STEMnasium, where they bring and create robots and they compete with one another with robotics. It's just going to be awesome. Hopefully this opportunity of a new STEM building will give our children to be better prepared when they get to college, because what we're finding now is that the ACT readiness benchmark in science reasoning is a 24. And when you peel the onion back on that ACT readiness in science reasoning for 24, you find out that our children, where they're lacking the most on, is exposure in actual labs, being able to create actual problems and seeing it done in a lab.
Talking to Dr. Hunter about the state assessments, and we actually analyzed those areas on the test where students perform poorly or areas to strengthen. Labs and investigations fall in that category. In order for students to take that theory and go to practice, they need those hands-on experiences. We've put out students who can, they know the knowledge, they have the knowledge, but they haven't necessarily been successful because of the experience. We lack the equipment. We lack the ability to do those things. And so we're teaching and teaching and teaching, not having all the necessary things in order to develop the students so that they're better equipped to have success on those state assessments. Again, it's proven that we've done well, but imagine how much better we would do if we had all of the resources in place in order to expose the students to the same evolving curriculum that is now pushing our students pass where they are currently.
In the last 6 years, Whitehaven has earned over $750 million in scholarship offerings. After this year, our projection, we should have over $1 billion in scholarship offerings for our children. Of that billion, less than 5% has been athletics. So it's been all academically based. So we have a huge understanding of what it takes to be successful after high school. So we're very proud of that. Our biggest challenge is not getting children to college. Our biggest challenge is having children, once they get to college, being able to stick and stay. One mission, one vision, one voice. Continued academic excellence for the Whitehaven community. See the vision through the eye of the tiger.